Sonia Zahn has been looking at the healthcare industry overall. And Sonia, earlier you were saying we've been taking notes from other countries, so we might be kind of in a better position. Is that correct?
Yeah, we're certainly at an advantage, a small one, but still there's a lot to that. Look, as we see this virus spread across America, our hospitals and healthcare workers are really preparing for what comes next. They have been doing that. They no doubt will, this is going to take a heavy toll on them as well. So you may be wondering, do our hospitals have the capacity if things get worse? And this is sort of that worst case scenario for those of you who that's where your minds go. According to the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, even a moderate pandemic will require 865,000 people to be hospitalized. But the American Hospital Association says the number of beds available for intensive care in the U.S. right now is 1/10 of that. U.S. health officials are working with a variety of companies to help to boost the level of medical supplies available. Washington State really has been the hardest hit with this virus. We are already seeing the impact there. Hospitals in Seattle now restricting visitors, only allowing exceptions for caretakers, spouses, or end-of-life visits. And nursing homes there are now banning all guests, leaving families locked out. And most hospitals are preparing for an influx of patients, and every hospital is different in their approach. Here in North Texas, I can tell you officials are monitoring 7 cases still. A reminder that nearly 70,000 people, okay, you guys, have recovered from this virus across the globe. And for people who have specific questions about the hospital systems here, what is this hospital doing and this one and this one? We don't know, and they're not going to tell us. Mm-hmm. That is just how the game is played right now. I know that's not a sufficient answer for a lot of you, and I wish I had different news, but that's just the way it is.
Well, thanks for keeping us up to date. I know it's been a lot of work lately, but appreciate it, Sonia. Mm-hmm.